This is a Mazda MX-5, it's a 1.8 two-door, 2008 on a 58 plate, although it does have a kind of MX-5 plate on it. I think it's MX-55 WAG. Take that to mean what you will. It has done 67,743 miles, two registered owners. The fuel economy is urban 28.5, extra urban 48.7, and combined 38.7. 0-60 time of 9.4 seconds, top speed of 122 miles per hour, 124 brake horsepower engine with 16 valves. It's got a charge speed colour-coded body kit on it. It has side skirts, the front bumper's different. It's got a rear spoiler on. Looks quite horny, really. It's not bad at all. Red leather, black hood. It's got XXR chromium black alloys. Again, set the car off nicely. And it's got this Pioneer CD, DVD, radio, Bluetooth hands-free, and it's a good spec. And as probably everybody knows, the MX-5 is the sports car that everything else is modelled on or compared to. Quite a loud exhaust. Just make sure my microphone isn't peaking. It looks like it might be. Turn that down a little bit. There's not many places to fix the cameras in, really, and with the being no frame around the windows, it is going to be a little bit shaky, so I'll do my best to keep it down, but it's fairly hard suspension on it. On this, it's adjustable too. It's got big wheels on it as well, and the roads round Waltonydale aren't very good at all. Aftermarket CD radio, and I'll just check, but I don't think the volume control is actually fastened to it or wired up to it. We'll just see. Oh, it is. They must have paid extra to get the special loom for it. So yeah, that's good. Five-speed box, really slick. Gear change. Got this piano black inset to the dash. The red leather is unmarked. Hood comes down in no time at all. Faster than electric hood and quicker to put back up, really. It's just two catches here. Centre one there. Just go straight back. There we go, give it some gas. sound system in here. That's streaming from my iPhone. So you have got Bluetooth hands-free and audio streaming. Coming off the trim at the back here. Ride on the motorways, not too bouncy at all. A little bit of wind noise from the back. I think it's probably off the wider tyres. December. There was a couple of advisories. The rear tyres, it does have adjustable suspension, and although the tyres were new, the suspension was adjusted too low, so it was catching the inner wings. And it's marked the outside of the tyres, so it does need two new tyres on. Although they're only advisories, but just to be on the safe side. Thudding along the road. You can still hear that Harley. He's just giving it some gas going up the hill there. Trim vibration out. Exhaust, it resonates at the back and sets the trim off. Well, the noise is just from behind my head in the back here where the hood folds in. Fiat 124 Spider version of the new MX-5 when I was on holiday, and that tremendous, sounded a lot like this, to be honest. Very throaty exhaust. a terribly bumpy road. It's a wonder anybody buys a car from us, because the roads around Preston are absolutely shocking. There's potholes everywhere. It's very difficult to find a smooth road. Drive though. It'd be great on the summer's day, this car. Cup holders in the doors there. We've got electric door mirrors. We've got remote central locking. We've got two keys for it. I did notice in the history there's a bill for a headlamp conversion, which I'm presuming is a high intensity beam or something that's been sent over from Japan. I went out in a few weeks ago, and I couldn't believe how fantastic the engine sounded considering it was a diesel. But apparently there's a noise is played through the speakers, but it's the trim that makes this even more throaty. Once you stick that down, I think it'll be fine though. But I'm not sure how anybody could drive around with it like that.